Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope so you all are fine and fit at home. Kids, myself Sangeeta and I am your computer science teacher. Dear, in our class 7, we're going to learn many interesting things. We're going to learn about Windows 7, computer virus. You're going to learn about internet and additional features of Microsoft Excel. Understood? And our very first chapter is about introduction to computer. There are few things you might have learned in your previous classes itself. Dear, in our first chapter, we will be learning about computer hardware, software, relationship between hardware and software, and very important thing, we will learn to know about the configuration of computer. It is very important thing. If anybody asks you, dear, what is the storage of your computer? What's your processor? Which generation you are using? So it is necessary we should know about the config of your system, configuration of our system. I will teach you how to know about it. Okay, and then we're going to focus about, sorry, then we're going to learn about troubleshooting tips. Now, troubleshooting is nothing else. Sometimes a system gets hanged up or any issues there. There are certain things which we itself can resolve it. If it is not possible from our end, then it's true we have to go to the trained person who will resolve it. So there are certain tips which we can do it from our end itself, from user end itself, that I will taught you what were all the troubleshooting tips. And then we will be learning about the data hierarchy. So kids, these were all the things which will be covered in our first chapter. So students, tell me, what is computer? Yes, very good. It is an electronic device which helps us in many ways. It is used everywhere, like in schools, colleges, railway station, even in a small shop for business purposes. Everywhere it is used, right? This computer is categorized into two ways. Like one is hardware and another one is software. In short, the hardware and software together makes a computer. Understood, my dear? Well, now what does hardware tell me? Yes, hardware are those devices which you can see with your naked eyes and you can touch and feel it, right? So you can touch your keyboard and you can feel it. So it is a hardware devices. Now, what is software? It is a program which helps to operate the computer parts. Clear? You cannot see with your naked eyes. Are you able to see the Windows 7 in all? No. So it is an program. Clear what I said? So dear students, this hardware is again divided into four devices. So number one is the input device. Second, output device, processing device, and the storage device. Understood? Now, today in our first session, in our first class, we're going to focus about the input device. Clear? Now, kids, what does input device tell me? Very good. The device which helps us to input the data, right? So, what are the commonly used device tell me? Very good, my dear. It's an keyboard, mouse, with the help of that we are giving input to the computer. Now I'm going to explain you some other input devices. First we'll focus on scanner. What we're going to see about a scanner. Now kids, scanner is nothing else. It helps us to scan the images, photographs and any documents directly into the computer. For example, you are able to see this book. If I want this picture in my computer, what I will do? I will simply scan it. Clear? So scanner is a device which is used to scan your physical document into the computer. Understood? There are two commonly used scanners. One is a flatbed scanner and another one is a handheld scanner. In the screen, are you able to see flatbed scanner? Yes. It has a flat surface made of glass where the item to be scanned is placed. You can see the image itself. In the glass, we have put one paper. You can see the image. So that is a place where you have to keep the document which to be get scanned and directly stored in your computer. And another device, this flatbed is used in your schools, colleges. It is widely used. You might have seen also in cyber cafe and all. And the another device which is used is a handheld device. What it is? Handheld scanner. It's again, you might have seen in Reliance Mall, in any shopping malls you might have seen. For scanning purpose they were using for the barcode and all, you might have seen. See, in the screen I have displayed you the image of handheld scanner. This scanner is used by dragging it over the object that is to be scanned. It is mostly used in shopping center. Understood, dear? So what is the input device which we learned today is a scanner. Now the another input device which we will be learning is a MICR, that is magnetic ink character recognition. Understood? Now in the screen, are you able to see the image of MICR? I think you might have seen this thing also in offices, they use in medicals also they use. This input device is used to read and identify magnetic character printed on a document. A best example is a check. In banks you might have seen, and in business purpose they widely use this. Clear? And the another input device which we're going to learn is the digital camera. You might be having in your home also, right? For what purpose digital camera is used? Yes, to take a photography. In the screen, I have displayed the picture of digital camera. This photograph from the camera can be transferred to the computer with the help of the data cable. You will be having the data cable. With the help of that, you can transfer the photos, that is the images from the digital camera to the computer, or else you can take the memory card from it, digital camera holding the memory card where all the data is stored. You can take the memory card. I have shown the image of memory card also, and you can read it with the card reader. It is a device which is available. I again showed the card reader in the screen. You can see the card reader is used to read the memory card, and you can copy the data to the system. Understood, my dear? Well, kids, another input device which we're going to learn is a drawing tablet. In the screen, are you able to see the image of drawing tablet? Good. So this is an input device. It is it having a board which has a special pen to write on it, and it is connected to the computer. The word, all the images you draw on this device can be directly stored in your computer. Now we're going to see the input device called touch screen. This also you might have seen in many places, like you have seen in the ATM also. Another best example is your phone, dear. You're having the touch screen phones and all, right? So these were all the good examples I have shown in the screen. The touch screen monitor has shown. It is a screen that can touch with your finger or input to input information. Example are the tablet, microphone, smartphone, monitor, ATM, etc. Clear? And the last input device which we're going to learn in today's session is the web camera. Might be you will be watching this video in your laptop. You can see the web camera is there. It is again an input device. It captures the image and it gets stored in your system. In the screen you can see the image of webcam. It is also called as a webcam or web camera. It is a video camera connected to a computer for capturing images and videos. It is a technology which is widely used in various fields for video conferencing and email and messaging. Today, many of you are attending Zoom classes which you are conducting through school with the help of the webcam, means through laptop you are connecting, which is carrying the webcam. So webcam is used for the video conferencing purpose. Understood here? So today in our first class, we just focused about the input device, which is one of the category of hardware, right? We have learned about the commonly used input device like scanner, two types of scanner, flatbed and the handheld scanner. We learned about the MICR, that is a magnetic ink character recognition for reading the checkbook, passbook and all. And then next we have learned about the digital camera for capturing the image. It is again an input device. Then we learned about the drawing tablet, which is used to draw the images and for writing purpose. It is again an input device. Thereafter we learned about the touch screen and web camera, which is again widely used. Touch screen, the best example is the ATM, and webcam for video conferencing purpose, in many places it is used. Well kids, with this I'm going to end our today's session. Today we have learned about the input device, and in our next class we will be focusing on, we will be learning about output device. Till then, bye bye, see you on next class.